Okay, so recently I've been going over cryptocurrency and NFT games, specifically as they pertain to the MMORPG industry and things like that, because we are seeing sort of a gold rush or a rat race with a bunch of projects coming out promising ridiculous things like photorealistic graphics with hundreds of thousands of people online on a single server, things that realistically don't exist even now without that technology shoehorned in as well. But obviously those things, those dreams, those promises are getting a lot of people really excited, usually not gamers, usually just, you know, speculative investors, the idea of these metaverses and things like that. And people are throwing hundreds of thousands of dollars at these things, and they're raising millions, hundreds of millions of dollars, sometimes like billion-dollar market caps and things like that. And then they basically, they don't have to exit scam. They can just exist in a perpetual state of doing nothing, you know, just trying to deliver on something and pay themselves handsomely from the money that they've made selling their tokens that they've made out of thin air, or their NFTs that they've made out of thin air. And today I wanted to give you the flip side of those grandiose games and just show you that you don't even have to have like a really ridiculous premise, a really big promise or anything like that, huge ideas. You just basically have to put the words cryptocurrency, NFT, blockchain with the word game, and people are just going to start throwing money at you, even if it does look from the surface level absolutely ridiculous. So this is Forgotten Chain. I'll show you the main webpage, just so you know that once you log onto this website, if you start immediately thinking, oh, I want to throw money at this, I don't really know what to tell you. It doesn't really look like something you should do. But Forgotten Chain is a massively multiplayer online role-playing game, MMORPG, DAOT, set in a player-driven, mysterious, fantasy universe. The project offers players an immersive in-game environment with four playable character classes and countless spells, abilities, and environments. And then obviously you can click website. Marketplace doesn't work yet. When you click website, it takes you to this complete amateur hour in terms of how the website's designed and things like that. But I just wanted to show you because they do have some teasers on their website. I've not watched this despite it showing that I have. I did click it earlier. And then we have this one as well. So we might as well go through these. I love the sound effects. It looks like an MMO that came from Korea in 2006 in terms of the graphics. It looks like Lineage 2. It probably looks worse graphically than Lineage 2, actually. Funnily enough. Those don't seem to suit the aesthetic whatsoever. So play to earn MMORPG. Let's check the other one. They have like such a ridiculously long intro. Get your mount today. Looks kind of like Silk Road Online graphics. Cool. Is this it? Are we just showing mounts? Mounts and racing teaser. Horse racing tournaments. Oh, he's just cheating. Man, I mean, looking at the comments, this is so great. I can't wait to start play. You'll probably be waiting for a while, mate. So we might as well just go over. I went through the AMA, skimmed through it. It seems like the person who's in charge of this, I googled him, can't find anything about him, googled the other people that he showed on the team. There's like five people working on the game apparently, two or three of which are developers, and I couldn't find any of them, but apparently one of them worked at Ubisoft, so there you go. And basically if you go start going through the website, it's pretty much what you come to expect, but there's a little bit of a nefarious element to this, as there usually typically is when you're talking about blockchain games. So I started going around and looking for, you know, social media posts and things like this, see if anyone's hyping this up, see what the commitment's like from their community. Earn your free plot of land now by doing quests in our Discord channel and winning giveaways. Don't forget to get your founder's badge because founders have first-hand sale in Ember. Only 1,000 members will have access to private sales. So straight away, you're hitting them with that FOMO, that fear of missing out, which is something that pretty much all of these projects do. And is one of the number one hallmarks of cryptocurrency anyway. I have cryptocurrency, by the way, before people start saying I'm a boomer and I don't understand the space. I do, I just don't understand why people buy into things that have no actual tangible worth right now, because you don't know if this game's even going to be good or exist in any kind of way. But they're hitting you with a FOMO, which all these NFT crypto games do. If you're one of the first 1,000 people, get in and maybe you're going to get rich. But the thing is about the founder role, there's an additional element to this. You can only get the founder's role by inviting people to their Discord. So here you go. Here's an invite to the Discord. Bonus for founders, currently at 500 out of 1,000, was at 300 this morning. This was a month ago. Looks like people are incentivized to go around to try and get people to click their invite link, which gives them credit towards becoming a founder. Looks like it takes 3 invite clicks to get to the founder's badge. OP, you should probably divulge that clicking the link helps you towards becoming a founder. Anyway, good luck with the game. So the thing with this is it almost operates like a pyramid scheme, right? A multi-level marketing scheme, whatever you want to call it, same difference. You cannot become a founder and then have the privilege of buying into their limited time sales without inviting other people, which means you're incentivized to, you know, hook your friends in with some bait to get them in, you know, like, oh, grandma, do you want to come in, buy some forgotten chain with me? Which is obviously a really negative thing that you would have attributed to a project usually. This isn't like an affiliate system or something like that, which is very commonplace. This is like, you know, it does operate exactly like a multi-level marketing would, other than, you know, you're not actually buying in first. You're inviting people to have the privilege to then buy in, which is kind of ridiculous. So their Twitter doesn't exactly inspire me with confidence when you go through it. Obviously, they have some images here. I'm not going to go through and find the assets that they're using, which they almost certainly are, because they always are in my experience. I might be wrong on that. I guarantee someone in the comments will let me know exactly what they're using or if these are actually original. But there is also FOMO in here as well, you know, earn your free plot, the founders badges, things like that. Only 1,000 people can get it. And then also they do have a 50% sale, a huge 50% sale on their first NFT sale on their website. I know if you join now, you get a 300% Ember boost, Ember being the cryptocurrency that they're using, that they're selling. And then the upcoming ICO, initial coin offering, think of it like an IPO, basically the first time you offer your cryptocurrency to the public. And the light version, according to their white paper, the light version is like a completely basic game that just has almost no features compared to what the real game would have, which is just like, I guess, something to do. It's kind of like building hollow buildings on Earth 2 or something like that. They give you a little bit of something, you know, just a little sniff, two little grains of cocaine before they potentially give you an actual full experience, a full line. So mostly because the audit for the token is taking a long time, which we did not expect. So for anyone who isn't aware of it, we won't be able to get the contract if we don't conduct an audit. So, you know, we'll see if they pass their audit. This was on September 24th. They've not posted anything since then in regards to whether or not they passed. So who knows about that? So for me, this is a really good example to just show you that you don't even really have to have, you know, crazy graphics and crazy ideas or anything like that to just get people to shill for your project of their own volition. And shill is a word that people misuse all the time, and I'm misusing right now. Shill means that you're paid to promote something, basically, you know, like hiding a payment and then pretending you're a normal citizen, a normal person, you've not been paid. But the problem is with NFTs and cryptocurrency in gaming, and just in general anyway, you don't have to be paid because you have a financial incentive just by default, because you're not going to promote a game if you don't already own some of the underlying asset, which is the cryptocurrency or the NFTs. So basically they're preying on that, all of these games. They're basically saying, or you know, if we can even call them games, these projects, these teams, they basically say like, oh, do you want to get rich? Well, you can get into our cryptocurrency and our NFT sale. Just invite a bunch of people, you know, go spread the word, be our guerrilla marketing, and then you have the privilege of buying these things that we just created out of thin air based on absolutely no evidence that we can deliver on anything that we've said. And to be fair to them, to be honest, they might be able to deliver on this game because it looks, I mean, you know, I'm not one for graphics specifically, but if you were going to sell me on like this revolutionary new idea, maybe this is where it needs to start. maybe it does need to start with like outdated graphics and things like that and look like an old game, but I'm not getting excited for this. Like, we can play games like this just without blockchain and without cryptocurrency and without NFTs. And one of the things that I think those systems solve, which a lot of people may disagree with me on, I'm not against the idea of blockchain in gaming, because I understand that ownership of your own assets in a game is probably something that would benefit most people. And yes, obviously it turns the game into potentially pay to win, but I do understand that MMOs are pay to win anyway. They have been for a long time now, and even before they were pay to win, from the developers selling the pay to win, RMT was a big thing anyway. It's just always played a factor at the top end of the game. So I'm not against this idea. I compare it to like Steam Marketplace. Like, when I quit CSGO, I can go and sell my, you know, my knife skin on the marketplace and then use that money to, you know, buy games for the next couple of years or whatever, or maybe go buy skins in a different game. And it's like that, only much more open, which obviously has some issues in other places. But I'd rather have that system than developers removing the ability to trade full stop and making games into like single player experiences like Black Desert Online, where all the market is controlled, all the items are untradeable, and you just, you know, you're not really playing an MMO at that point. I think NFTs do and can have a place and the blockchain in gaming, but not this way, not with selling people on all these things before a game's even been shown or played by anybody, by a team that you can't verify who they are. And yeah, I just wanted to show you this because it's not always a case that they're showing you something ridiculously grand that is promising to do all the best things ever. It can just be this. It can just be a game that looks, you know, it looks like something you'd have played 10 years ago and completely forgotten about by now. And people are still willing to jump headfirst into this to buy the tokens on the idea that they will get rich. So yeah, there you go. Thank you very much for watching as always. If you do enjoy these videos, leave me a like, drop a comment down below. Helps the video in the algorithm, which means that I'll do more of these. So thank you very much. See you on the next one. Hopefully stay safe. We out. Peace.